The only way to get the most out of your 3D printer is getting some CAD skills. Today I want to add something new to your toolbox, a simple method to recreate any thread you've got in your hands or even make your own from scratch. We'll go through all the steps, from measuring it to modeling it in Fusion to printing and testing the final piece. I'm Salveo and this is your daily dose of functional printing. All you need are four parameters, so grab your caliper and let's start. The first measurement we need is the external diameter. It's the maximum extension of the thread, its widest diameter. Then we'll measure the internal diameter, which is basically the cord the thread wraps around. Next, we need the pitch, the distance between the peaks in the spiral. If the thread isn't sharp pointed, like in this case, measure between the middle of one wall and the next. And finally, count the number of revolutions, the total turns the thread makes from start to end. Custom threads often have unique cross sections. Take a close look. You can sketch it on paper to figure out the measurements you'll need. In my case, the shape tapers outward. I'll measure its height both near the curve and the outer edge. Now we have everything we need to start modeling. I suggest creating a table in the Parameters tab. This way, we can easily manage the different diameters and make quick adjustments to the model. Create a cylinder using the internal diameter you measured. This will be our base. Now we'll generate a helical path or spring that will define the spiral of the thread. Let's select revolution and pitch in the drop-down menu. These are exactly the parameters we measured earlier. Now, enter the internal diameter in the diameter field and fill the number of revolutions and pitch in their boxes. Choose a triangular section and place it on the inside. The section size doesn't really matter, we're just using this spiral as a guide. If you get an error, try reducing the section size a bit. Now we can sketch the thread profile on the bottom face of the coil we just created. Use the measurements you sketched to draw the thread section. The tip of the triangle lines up with the inner diameter and the outermost point should match the external diameter. Now we can create the actual thread using the sweep command. Choose the option Path plus Guide Surface. Use the profile we sketched, select the edge of the triangle as the path and the top surface of the spiral as the guide. Don't forget your fillets on the top edge to improve thread engagement. I proceeded to model the rest of the bottle cap to have a complete piece. Now it's time to export and print. From Futura sent over some of their Galaxy PLA, and the finish of this print looks really good and hides the layer lines perfectly. You can now test the fit. If it feels too tight or hard to screen, you can slightly reduce both the internal and external diameters. And that's it. Your custom thread is ready. And that's your daily dose of functional printing. I hope you learned something new from this video. Consider subscribing and leaving a comment below. See you in the next one. Ciao.